Hello, my name is Christian Walter from TradeVola, and today I want to talk a little bit about CFD trading, how to find the right CFD, what is important. First of all, for the CFD trading, I always recommend to do this with the Trader Workstation platform in the client portal or in the IBKR mobile app is also possible, but I think it's a bit easier with the Trader Workstation desktop version. So for example, I can show you Tesla as an easy example. We have here stocks, options, all the different markets where you can trade Tesla, if it's in Mexico or in Switzerland or in Germany. And then you will always find the selection CFD. So you click on this selection of CFD, and then it will normally ask you if you want to add also the underlying, the same like we did it here with Apple. But as this gives you not more information than the CFD itself, it doesn't make any sense to add it to this overview. So in this case, I just click to no. I see here the Tesla CFD, and maybe as Apple is going a little bit up, I will present it for you with the Apple CFD. You just select the CFD in the watch list, and then it will automatically here come. You select your quantity, and then I will place the order, and you will see here the most important is the margin impact. Instead of paying $13,000 for my position, I just need to have a margin of 2,100 euros. So it's approximately like 20% what you need for this instead of the 13,000. So we will transmit this order. And as you can see, we are already invested here. The difference is for a smaller account, of course, it makes sense to think about CFDs, but don't forget if you have or if you are trading in a buy and hold strategy where you really want to hold this CFD position for a longer period of time, there's the interest what you need to pay in the CFD. So I always recommend for a short period of time or intraday trading, CFD is really interesting because it's not part of the pattern day trading rule, and especially for smaller accounts you can easily trade Tesla or Facebook, Apple, everything what might be too expensive to really buy bigger positions in the stock itself. For this, it's quite interesting to think about the CFD. To make maybe another example, what makes it maybe a little bit clearer is Amazon. Amazon, we have the same stock, options, warrants, and so on. We will go here as well to the CFD. Don't forget that not every stock or not every indice, I don't know, but not every stock is really having also a CFD on the other hand side. So if you find a mid cap or some smaller position, you might not find a CFD for this, but mainly the big companies, they also have all a CFD here listed. So here we have Amazon. Amazon, if I want to buy 100 shares, I have to invest, in this case, $300,000, more than $300,000. And I think this example makes it pretty clear. I will buy 100 Amazon. Yeah, here comes already the information, even for the CFD, I don't have enough margin, but we can maybe make it a little bit smaller. And then here, 166,000 USD I will need if I want to buy 150 Amazon stocks. Of course, if you have a margin account, you don't need all these money. But related to this, I only need 27,000 euro because euro is my base currency for a position here in Amazon as a CFD. So the advantage, to summarize it, it's I think pretty simple. You're not part of the pattern day trading rule, and as well, you don't need so much money to place a position. But everything buy and hold or on a longer period of time, I would say makes not so much sense because you need to check the interest here. All this information you find directly on the IB website, but if you have any other CFD broker, really check for the spreads, what they offer you, because that's also a quite interesting thing, because if I check the Book Trader, my spread is the same at the end like what I have normally for, or you can see it here, we can see it here, the spread is just 1 cent, it's exactly the same like in the stock. So from this side I think it's really fair, and not all CFD brokers will offer you the same, so really double check all the costs, commission, for the commission I will also show you again. You can see here already we are now $2 in profit after we opened the position, and now we want to try to close this position with some profit. We just go here to Apple CFD, 100 shares, we sell it a little bit higher than we bought it, what's always the idea of trading, and yeah, if I go again to submit, I see my commission is $1. Just to show you, for 200 is then $2, that's pretty easy and simple to handle, and then I transmit my order, and it also already shows you that your margin impact will also go back from 4000 back to the normal level. Now we just have to cancel the order because it's already going a little bit higher than what we want to sell it. Yeah, looks like, no, it was not executed, now it was executed. Yeah, so we made another few dollars profit with, we bought it at 130.28, so it was only $1 what we generated, but as I said, Apple looks pretty good today, and here we had these two examples for the CFDs, and to summarize everything, put all the CFDs together, save this list so you can have this watch list in your IB Care mobile app as well as in the client portal itself, and in the rest you can also operate here with the same like in stocks. You can add to your buy or sell position attached stop and target, what I always recommend if you trade intraday, to make sure that you don't risk too much, and also to make sure that you generate some profit when the target is reached. So in the end there's only the main differences, the cost structure, and that it's totally different asset classes, what means the regulation is also different. If you don't want to miss any of the upcoming video, I will be happy if you subscribe to our channel, and would like to welcome you next time here again. Thank you very much.